So one of the things that I certainly sense in the ether, and I think many others do too, is that we're in a bad place right now. The country's in a very bad place because everything just seems unstable. Everything just seems unstable and feeble and haphazard. And I think this poll that just came out sort of verifies that this isn't something just I'm feeling or just you're feeling. This is like a widespread. Like, people know something's off, right? Ever since, I mean, shit, probably 2016 and on, it's just been like we're holding on for dear life and every year is worse than the last, right? So look at this. Poll. Many Americans expect election-related violence over future losses. Nearly a majority of U.S. adults believe there will be violence regarding future presidential election losses, new polling reveals. 3 years out from the January 6th insurrection at the U.S. Capitol, and only months away from the 2024 presidential election, over two-thirds of Americans feel that democracy is under threat. So here are the specific numbers. 51% of respondents expect the losing side to accept their losses peacefully, so a very slight majority. There's a CBS YouGov poll. But 49% expect violence over those losses. Look, I would love to know what that number was in, like, 1992, right? Because my guess is it was, like, 90-10. 90% were like, of course there's not going to be violence. 10% said there would be violence. Now we're at, it's basically 50-50. 70% of respondents believe U.S. democracy is under threat, while 30% feel democracy is secure. So an overwhelming majority, no. Yeah, our democracy is massively under threat. Our democracy is under threat in multiple ways, by the way. The Democratic Party in Florida just canceled the Democratic primary because they want Biden to win. They don't want Dean Phillips or Marion Williamson or Jenkins, where they just canceled the primary. Tennessee Democrats canceled the primary. Massachusetts Democrats canceled the primary. North Carolina Democrats canceled the primary. They just canceled it. The DNC came out the other day and said, we're just not going to count the New Hampshire votes because we don't want them to go first. And even though being first in their is in their state constitution, so they have to do it, we're just going to ignore all of their votes and all the democratic will of the voters is there. We're just not going to screw them. So in that sense, we are living under a threat to democracy. There is no primary process. There's this talk about, like, not even having debates, right? As if that should be a thing. If you want to be in the most powerful position in the world and you don't present your case in front of your opponents, the American people, that's all threat to democracy. And of course, we had the fake elector scheme, the fraudulent elector scheme. We had January 6th. We had all this talk about maybe invoking the Insurrection Act or seizing the voting machines from Trump. Now he's refused to sign a pledge that he wouldn't overthrow the government again. And so there's threats everywhere. There's threats to democracy everywhere. 70% of the country agrees that whatever we got going on here is broken. This comes as 39% of respondents do not consider President Biden to be the legitimate winner of the 2020 presidential election per the poll. Let me repeat that. 39% in this poll say Biden is not the legitimate winner of the 2020 presidential election. That's 4 out of 10. No, he didn't win. There is zero evidence for the idea that he didn't win. 4 out of 10, believe it. Yet multiple probes and recounts of the 2020 election votes have disproven claims of widespread election fraud. 78% of respondents disapprove of the actions taken by the people who forced their way into the U.S. Capitol on January 6th. This is the most positive result in this poll, that almost 80% say that January 6th was bad and wrong. That figure included 70% of Republicans, 82% of independents, and 84% of Democrats. So even 70% of Republicans were against January 6th. The percentage of Republicans who strongly disapprove of those actions on January 6th, 32%, has dwindled nearly 20 points since January 2021. That's not good, when that figure stood at 51%, according to the poll. Over a third of respondents described the actions of the people who forced their way into the U.S. Capitol on January 6th as defending freedom. Over a third said they were defending freedom. 59% of Republicans felt this way, as opposed to 28% of independents and 18% of Democrats. 3 years since the January 6th riot, over 1,265 people have been charged with crimes related to January 6th, according to the U.S. Attorney's Office for D.C. Okay, so some really interesting findings in this. I guess the silver lining is that still at this late date, most Americans are like, yeah, January 6th was stupid and wrong. That's good. But everything else in this scares me. The political violence stuff scares me, that everybody sort of senses something bad is coming. I agree. I don't know how we avoid a bad scenario, right? If Trump wins the primary and wins the general, we get 4 years of Trump. That's a disaster. If he wins the primary and loses the general, he's just going to say he won. We're right back to January 6th type stuff, right back to election subversion type stuff. If he loses the primary, he won't accept it. He'll say he won the primary. Bodies in the streets, potential riots, you know, if Trump wins, you could have riots in the sense that the left is like, this is unacceptable. And if Trump loses, you could have his people riot. Like, everything just feels unstable and unsteady. And clearly, that's reflected in the polls by a majority. So I'm not alone in thinking, and you're not alone in thinking it.
Hey, y'all, do me a favor and like and subscribe. It helps out big time in the algorithm. Click the bell as well for notifications when videos drop. And watch that video on screen right now. You know you want to.